I didn't get that part.
Yeah, that's gonna be about $2.50.
Good morning, guys. It's Kelsey here. Welcome back. I am in my pajamas. Who says pajamas like that? Who says pajamas? Pajams? I was going to say pajams. That's why. Okay, so I'm in my pajamas. Don't judge me because, like, comfort is the most important thing to me right now. I'm, like, getting so uncomfortable. Tight clothes. Everything. I'm just like, if I could just run around with nothing on, I would do that, but I don't think that's socially acceptable. So anyways, we are hanging out in the nursery right now, and we're just gonna kind of like organize some stuff. It's pretty messy in here, and I feel like we need to definitely get this space more organized for if he comes sooner than later. We have been having ultrasounds and growth scans and non-stress tests and biophysical profiles and just a bunch of doctor's appointments, just checking up on him and, you know, for them to figure out when they're going to want to induce me. But he's been looking good. Everything has been good so far. Yeah, we'll talk a little bit more about the appointments as we go, but we're gonna bust into some boxes and just start like organizing this room a little bit.
Whoa!
Wow.
Okay, we're getting somewhere.
The dog got scared.
What do we got here? That's what it looks like?
Yeah, I think it's white.
Yeah.
It's nice,
it's
right?
It's white? Titanium white? Or just white?
Just white, babe.
Just white.
Ooh, I'm excited. And we got the little bags for it, too. Ooh.
Okay.
Lift it up. It's kind of smaller than I thought it would be, but I guess,
well, see,
I mean,
the box,
you don't want it to be massive.
Yeah, I was expecting it to be
short.
I mean, yeah, because, like,
that slides forward.
Oh, there you go. So it's like, if you're like this, and you do this, boop, drop it. Boom. That's it.
It's pretty good.
It's very natural.
Is it natural? All right, do you want to open it up? And then those are the bags for it on the dresser.
The plastic bags. We've got the plastic.
Oh my gosh, my filming is so bad today.
What do you call them? No, that's not what you call them.
Plastic.
No, you don't call them
plastic bags.
Plastic bags.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, that's a cute purple plastic bag.
Holy smokes. Those are big. Yeah, I want to, like, clear, like, this whole area and get it all set up and ready. We'll do as much as we can today. This laundry basket full of clothes, and we chose all of the like the 0 to 3 or maybe up to 6 months.
Up to six.
We're gonna wash the clothes that are up to 6 months, and the other clothes that are 6 months and older we put up there since we're not gonna need them right away. So pretty much the drawers are empty for clothes right now. And I'd like to figure out where we're going to put his changing pad and then maybe put some diapers and set up like a little changing station.
Well, that's going to be over here.
Yeah. So we can work on that.
All right.
All right, so we're gonna start to open the crib. I'm gonna lay it down. The mini crib. All
right. Let's open that like an animal.
Like an animal?
Yeah.
So all that's left is to put the mattress on.
Easy enough. It was like easy. I mean, it was just.
Yeah.
It takes you longer to look at the instructions because it's so tiny than to actually set up. There we go.
Cute.
Maybe bed.
Good,
cute.
Right?
I can't even.
It's so cute. It's nice. Just need to get a little sheet that fits it and it'll be good. Alright, so I just want to show you the progress we've made so far. Obviously, we set up the crib. This high chair is not going to be here. That bassinet is not gonna be there because that will be in our bedroom. But there's the crib. And then on the dresser, we got the diaper pail and the changing mat. We have the diaper caddy. We put some diapers in there, some wipes, a little changing mat, some burp cloths. And then we've got the wipes warmer, which will eventually get plugged in. And I'm trying to turn on some lights so you can see. And then our little light. We mounted the alpaca. And we also put this little shelf up. Sorry if I'm out of breath. with a few little trinkets. Something from my nursery when I was a child. And we organized the drawers a little bit. So we have diapers, wipes, and butt cream. And then we have like extra wipes, and this is like stuff for like when your baby's sick. And then I've got some like nipple pads and nipple butter for me, baby like essentials, hairbrush, stuff like that, some pacifier stuff. And this drawer isn't final or anything. But yeah, so that's what we've done so far. What's happening?
She's trying to eat the rug.
Don't eat the rug.
Hey, stop licking it, Todd. Can you get out of my legs? Stop. What is your problem?
So later today, we're going to go and do some laundry. Got to find a place for this little hippo, which is so cute.
He was living right up there.
Oh, you want to put him back up there?
Just leave him up.
Okay, I'll put him up after. But he lights up the room and also speaks in French. Oh, I forgot. I left that drawer open. Okay, so we're going to open up this baby dome thing. And while we do, Vanessa is going to explain what's been happening at our last two doctor's appointment. Oh,
why me?
Because you love talking.
Well, I mean, what am I going to say? Like, oh, we went there and we changed our appointments. Wasn't too happy.
Well, what happened last appointment? Last Thursday.
Last appointment.
When I was 32 weeks, right?
Yeah. 32 weeks, they did the, what's it called?
The non-stress test.
Non-stress test, but that was afterwards.
Okay, right. So they did the ultrasound.
Right.
And the biophysical profile.
Right, so they look at like what? Like the size of all the limbs and all that.
Yeah,
stuff.
They like actually measured his growth.
Right, and then see if he's breathing or trying. Yeah,
practice, you know? Breathing, and they check the fluid, and they look for movement and stuff.
Yeah, they do that. And then they said that he was in what, 76th
percentile. Yep.
But then he had a big old gut.
They said that his belly size was in the 96th percentile.
They said he had a good layer of fat on there.
So they said his belly was a little bit big, but the rest of him was looking normal and average and good. And his weight was
5 pounds, 4 ounces.
Yes, 5 pounds, 4 ounces.
Yeah.
So.
Also, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just going to let
just keep
right
doing. Looks great to me. So
then
we had the non-stress test, and obviously he did great on that.
Yeah.
And the doctor said that he looked a little bit big, and they wanted my fasting sugars to be a little bit lower, so they added Novalin,
yeah.
Something like that.
A
second injection of
insulin after your... before you go to bed.
Before you go to bed.
It targets one number in particular.
It targets 8 hours after it's injected,
right,
I guess.
Right.
So, I started on that, which is great. My numbers have been great. And he also mentioned that it might be looking like inducing me around 38 weeks rather than 39 weeks.
Well, you were like, oh, you think I'm going to make it until 39, which they had told you before that clearly you would. But then...
Right.
He was like, maybe more towards 38 instead.
Right.
All right.
Which is fine. I feel like we'll see what happens as we go week by week.
Right. Yeah.
So that was last week at 32 weeks. And then today, at 33 weeks, we went again. And what did they say?
What they what happened? What was...
Well, they said that I missed my ultrasound appointment because they had changed it on me the day before of the appointment but didn't tell me. So I was an hour late to an appointment that I didn't realize that they had bumped up by an hour. Regardless, they got me into the non-stress test first, which he did great. He was moving all around. He was kicking. He had the hiccups. I'll try to put in a clip of his, like, hiccups. I tried to get a video of his movement, but he's really tough to get on video. So this was the non-stress test. Okay.
Oh, oh. Yo.
Mm-hmm.
Calm down, bro.
He moving.
How are they going to do the ultrasound if he keeps moving like that?
Well, they want to see him moving.
I know. Oh, 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 I'm going up. Yeah.
Come on, buddy.
I saw it on the blue.
Yeah. Oh, ooh, there was one. You know, he just is. Now I laugh, but.
Yeah, but I saw it.
He did a kick.
It's funny.
We did another one.
Yeah, you can get another hiccup.
No.
No, no.
I don't know what he's doing, but he keeps kicking that blue one.
He doesn't like it.
Yo. Maybe he has the hiccups. No, he stopped.
Oh.
Oh, he's got the hiccups.
Yeah. And sometimes hiccups, they're not all, always every, like, 3-4 right. seconds. Sometimes, you know, you think you got rid of it.
Yep.
Oh, he's spiking. Yeah. Whoa. Yeah, plus the sound gives it away.
Mm-hmm.
Heart.
It's just him.
Holy fuck.
Every time he makes that noise, I feel it in my belly.
Yeah. Well, I can see it.
Yeah.
On the on your belly, I can see the fucking thing move. He's got the hiccup. You gave him the water. He's got the hiccup now.
He needs a drink. And then after the non-stress test today, they were able to squeeze me in to get the ultrasound. But what did we find out about the ultrasound that we didn't realize?
That they weren't gonna measure him or do anything like that.
Right.
The only thing they would do is to see if he was moving and
doing the practice breathing.
Right. Which,
yeah.
I mean, I get it, but like, is that necessary then to do an ultrasound just for that once a week?
Yeah, I don't know. So they said that they wouldn't do the measurement.
I mean, I'm not a doctor, but...
Yeah, I'm not an ultrasound tech. I'm not a doctor. I don't know. But we were expecting that they were going to do a growth ultrasound every...
This is big. I thought it was going to be much smaller.
Really?
I guess. I'm not a baby.
He'll be able to be in it for a while then.
Yeah. I'm just like...
It's not looking legit on the back side. Okay. Oh, there you go. It locked in place.
I don't know. Things is like cracking. I don't know. I'm just being like... Oh,
whoa.
There
we
go.
Whoa.
So you're going to be rough with it.
All right, so to finish my story, we thought that they were going to do a growth scan every single week and measure him every single week, but she said that they only do that every 4 weeks.
And that's wrong.
Yeah, apparently we were wrong.
So basically, next time he's going to get weighed is when you'll be 36 weeks.
And I'll be close to...
Which you'll be almost... He'll be almost... His head's going to be poking out.
Not really, but yeah, okay. I feel you.
Yeah, it's just... I don't know. It's
yeah.
And, you know, they're all worried about, oh, you're a high risk pregnancy because you got the diabetes. And then it's like, oh, yeah, we're not worried. Just
keep
in
up.
4 weeks.
Yeah.
Like, oh, we'll check it. We're not worried because, you know, it shouldn't happen. But then again, it's like, you need to be...
Yeah, it's tough because every single time we go, we see a different doctor.
Like it's always something different with them.
Right, and we're always getting new bits of information or contradicting bits of information, which is fine. But it's just tough to kind of follow and really know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
But, yeah, they're going to do the biophysical profile and the non-stress test every week. Not sure when I'm going to get another growth scan or they're going to measure his... weight and his length and all of that again.
Right.
But yeah. that is about it for an update on baby. Everything's been going good. This is the little Fisher-Price dome.
This is so cute.
Isn't it cute? And that other one comes up too, so you can close it all the way, and it's got like a sun.
Yeah, right here.
A sunshade.
Like this.
Yeah.
I think there's like, you can like.
Snap it or something.
Probably like this.
That's great.
I don't know if this,
and then at some point it closes back up. So, all right. Well, let me flip it around and I will finish out the vlog. So that is it for the. Oh yeah, we also put this shelf up.
Hey.
Talk about. Hey. I am like short attention span right now. But we put that one up with a few little cute things too. So that is it for the update on baby and for, you know, organizing this room, putting together the crib, which I didn't even think we were going to do today. So I feel like we got a lot done. I'm feeling good.
Yeah, in one day, I feel like I'm done.
And then this weekend, we're going to put in the car seat. We're going to make sure hospital bags are ready. We're going to be doing, you know, more stuff to the room. So we'll make sure to vlog this weekend as well so you guys can see any changes. And we will keep you up to date, but we will see you guys in our next video. Bye guys. Say bye, B.
Bye.